Dennis here, and welcome to an episode of Space Engineers, where today we've got two mods that give you some more power options. First, we've got Energy Plus by Maximine7080, and Advanced Power Systems 2 by Apathy Gates and Stone Lords. So, we'll take a look at Energy Plus first, which is set all the way back there. Is this too dark? Did we get put light over this area? Oh well, let's get going. And for this one. So the Energy Plus adds a bunch of items, like some solar panels, and that's just a tower, and some individual ones. Because, I mean, there are much larger versions of this. And then you got two reactors here. Now both these reactors are identical, they're just different styles at the base, as you can see. Then you got your plasma reactor. Yunk. That looks kind of funky. Is it supposed to look like that? Oh well. I think this is also a plasma reactor. I don't remember. Ew. Antimatter. I've got to check if we have fuel. Nothing there. Strange. And it's got a windmill. Big one. As well as a battery and a plasma battery, which can store quite a bit of power. Now the conveyor access for all these reactors are on the bottom, just a single one right in the center, which makes it easy to get to. And let's bring everything back. Let's go over the resource cost. First, this thing. This got about 30 steel plates, 90 construction components, 45 girders, 45 computers, and 100 solar cells. And 40 bulletproof glass. I think I missed that one. It's getting foggy. Oh well. But these two, which I think... same resource cost. Wait a minute. Probably needing more solar cells. It's identical to this one. Interesting. I guess you just place this on top of that one as well. To make solar wings or something. And these bugs are expensive. I think they're like just as expensive as vanilla. About 1,200 steel plates, 100 construction components, 200 metal grids, 100 large steel tubes, 2,500 reactor components, 10 motors, 100 computers. I think this one's the same. Yeah. And so you got panels to access them right here. Oops. This is the first one I can actually access, show you how much power it needs. Which at maximum output is 135 megawatts. For both of them. Which is pretty good. And compared to vanilla. I was about to get the azimuth one out then. That wouldn't help. Where did I put it? I guess I need it somewhere. There you are. Vanilla only makes 300 megawatts, so it is a little bit more. And this one is the plasma. Still look pretty weird. Which produces 400 megawatts. As it uses plasma ingots as fuel. Rather than uranium ingot. Yeah, it's not too bad. Come on, what about the antimatter? Ow. This produces 1 gigawatt, so it is actually quite powerful, but it uses an antimatter ingot. Funny thing is, it doesn't show up here. Oh, it might be going under a different name. Shouldn't it have shown up as an antimatter ingot? No idea. No wait, it's resource cost. Back to it. Oh, it's the same as all the reactors have the same cost. Ah, not really. It's the amount of reactor components is down to 2,000. Yeah. And it also uses a new item, which is in French. Can't really read the full name of the new item it needs, but you can make it in the assembler. I think this one needs the same. Yeah, that also needs it. 2,000 of it. And doesn't need any reactor components as well. But the rest of the materials are the same. And as for the big wind one, just slowed down quite a bit. Surprisingly. Need 100 steel plates, 600 interior plates, 80 motors, 200 construction components, 240 girders, and 20 computers. Top bucket. Then here we have the batteries. This being the large battery, this one the plasma. And this one can store a total of 6 megawatts. And this one can store 18. So the plasma can store triple, 3 times as much as the large. That's where the resource cost. It's 160 steel plates, 120 construction components, 160 power cells, and 50 computers. But the power cells are lost as scrap if you were to grind it down. Which is a little upsetting, but oh well. This bugger, it's same material cost. Yeah, but it just also includes the plasma unit, well, item, 240 of it, which is also lost as scrap metal when you grind it down. And something that these mod, or the other mod does, is that it has other items that get turned to scrap if you grind it down. Apparently, you can do that now, which is interesting. But how about we go over the power cost of the wind and solar farm? Well, the power that they provide. The little solar panels on the pillar can produce up to 500 kilowatts. So you have a farm of these things, which is pretty handy. And the other solar panels, when I find the buggers. The one that was like the tip. No, this one's the tip. 800 kilowatts. And the one that has mount ports on both ends, also 800 kilowatts. So it's not too bad. And what about the little wind farm? Not very little, still. There you are. When at maximum capabilities, it will produce 7 megawatts. So you can have a nice little farm of these things. Just gonna show up in the right place. Yeah. Still find a way how there's no antimatter ingot. In this menu. Oh yeah. Oh, it doesn't have an English name. That's a pain. Oh well, never mind. Anyway, how about we take a look at the resource cost of the components? Let's head over to the assembler and refinery. Which I've noticed they've been modified since they were released. I believe this is a vanilla modification. That you can now access the assembler from up here. Which is actually pretty handy. and you access the refinery from up here. Not sure when they did that. So one of the materials you're going to need is liquid plasma something, which you get from this, which I believe is an ore you can mine. Let's slap that in there, and it starts converting. I don't know the exact conversion rate, considering this particular refinery has a 141% efficiency, so you get more out of it. So I don't know the exact conversion rate. You see, we're not getting a lot. But I'm going to take a guess that 100 of the ore becomes 1 of this. As you see in a minute, yep, I'm right. So 100 converts into 1. Not too bad of a ratio. At least you'll be able to easily calculate how much you're going to get. There's for these. I'm going to shove this at you. Yeah, no protection. I don't know what this is for. I think this might be the antimatter, but I'm not 100% certain on that. Wait, unless that's the fuel for the plasma. And then you have this material, which obviously requires the same thing, as well as iron ingots, nickel ingots, and silver ingots. That just needs uranium ingots and that stuff. So that's all that. Still no idea where the antimatter comes from, but oh well. So how about we move over to the next mod, the Advanced Power Systems 2. Now there's a couple of blocks of this one. You can see solar panels, wind, batteries, engine. So first, let's take a look at these batteries, because this one's impressive. Look how big it is. And you see here, you've got the plates. Now these do light up depending on how much power it has. So you've got a really big indicator. But it's also got the lights on the side. This one has got the lights on the interior. Now, I didn't notice that was a triangle. This has a max capacity of 7 megawatts. Like this has a max capacity of 70 megawatts. Now it's going to take 2 years to deplete. Quite a long time. Let me see if this 60 steel plates, 160 steel plates, 60 construction components, 160 power cells, and 50 computers, which I think is the standard battery requirements for, well, resource requirements for batteries. Apparently. I haven't checked vanilla. Now this one, as you see, a hell of more. About 960 steel plates, 360 construction components, 960 power cells, and 300 computers. Expensive. Those are big. Right, let's take a look at the wind farm. Which is just a basic little thing, which has actually been designed. Not sure if it's intentional. I don't think it is, though. To be stacked. Yeah, like that. And oh my, it looks like a drill. Just a bunch of wind farms. Which I think is actually the most effective one you want to use in like urban areas. Like say they want to stop powering all the buildings in a city using wind. Just stick a couple of these on top and it should provide some power. Especially windy days. But anyway. This thing's resource cost is 100 interior plates, 56 motors, 40 construction components, 48 girders, which you get back as scrap for some reason, and 16 computers. So yeah, a cost all. That's how the advanced wind turbine, well, how much it cost. We'll get to how much they actually provide in a moment. And then you got the solar panels. All four solar panels are basically the same. One is just rotated compared to the other, and there's also the one in the middle of the block. In the middle block, which is the bottom one, and there's the offset one, which is at the edge of the block, which is the top one. Did I say it was the top one? Yeah. Yeah. With this one, you lose your solar cells if you grind them down, so you've got to be careful with these. And there's 16 steel plates, which doesn't seem like a lot. The 56 construction components, 48 girders, 16 computers, 128 solar cells, and 16 bulletproof glass. So yeah, costs quite a bit. And they do provide decent power for their size, which we'll get to once we've checked out this thing, which is a hydrogen engine. So it's just a small little thing. Takes up more space than that one over there. Is it? Oops, didn't need to drink. Yeah, it just takes up two blocks. One of the best items used to check that. That also takes two blocks. Wait a minute, that takes up more space. You see, it's got only one conveyor port for pumping fuel into this large tank. Although I have a feeling this has a greater hydrogen storage capacity than the vanilla, at 350,000 litres. How much can you store on your own? Oh, 100,000. So yeah, it has 3.5 times as much storage capacity. And as far as resource cost, yeah, 300 steel plates, 210 construction components, 36 large steel tubes, which you get turned to scrap metal when you grind it down, 60 small steel tubes, 38 motors, 12 computers, 3 power cells that turn to scrap when you grind it down. I'm not sure what the power cells are for, but anyway. Yeah, that's everything. As for the power it gives, it will give you a max output of 17 megawatts. And the vanilla? Okay, there we go. I'll use it 5 megawatts. Huh! Much greater storage and much greater output. Nice. Now, how about we take a poke at the solar panels? How much do they give? I find the buggers. They give you a max possible output of 1.9 megawatts, which can be pretty handy, especially if you have a large field of them. And set up in a way where they always look at the sun. You know, like this thing. Yeah. I need to wait for its data before it starts producing power again. Well, as for the wind turbines, they have a max output of 1.1 megawatts. Although, as you can see, it's not really optimal at the moment. Okay, this one is more than optimal. And that's one of the really high up ones. So, you see, it's producing, well, it can produce more than the optimal output would suggest it could. I mean, it's actually really good. So, this one is at the perfect height. Got a little interrupted there. As there's changes to the assembly and refinery, it looks like it was the most recent update. I didn't read that. Oh well. So as I was saying, it looks like starting from this one here is where the optimal conditions for these wind turbines starts. So it's not really all that high. So it's pretty easy to get the optimal output for these wind farms, which is good. How about I go turn off everything else that's producing power? Just to see how well they can do. Yeah, no punk. Now these ones still aren't doing the output because of everything else. And you go off. You go off. You also go off. And you go off. There's an output. Take the batteries. Where's the other ones? I've done it somewhere. That's not it. The solar panels. The turbine. No, here. Alright. These are putting out the power. Nice. Ooh. Ominous. They're all going red. Obviously. So that's basically all these. Not really much else to go over. Oh, that one stops too. So anyway, I'm gonna end this one here. And I'll have links for both mods in the description below. And I hope you enjoyed this video. If you have, please leave a like and even subscribe for episodes. And I shall see you all next time. Bye bye.